Ah, didn't see you there. It's me, Thomas Edward, also known as TE. And welcome to JJ, the MGZR. And today we're doing a full brake overhaul or brake refit. As it currently stands, JJ here has a 160 setup. What's the big engine brake setup off what? Not like Noel. But to be honest, it's not that great because it's still using a stock 1.4 master cylinder. And people say, oh, there's no difference in them, but there is a difference. They're not as good. These calipers with a stock master cylinder on doesn't really work that well. So we're going back to stock. We're bringing it back to OEM standard. Been to Rimmers, we've ordered some solid discs, 1.4 calipers, carriers, and we've got some EBC pads for him. So that's today's job. As you saw probably on the beginning, I had a bit of a struggle getting some of the nuts off, and that's to do with people, I won't say any names, but garages and other places taking them off with windy guns, and you shouldn't do them on these because these little chrome caps on them, what are integral to the nut, it just rounds them off. So you always should do them by hand. I didn't film, but I did have to fight with that one. I had to get an extension on it and a hammer and bang it with this big rubber hammer to get it off so it would fit on. Now I have got behind camera some brand new nuts, what we got off eBay, a whole set. So when this goes back on, it will have new 19mm nuts on it. And I say nuts because MGs and Rovers have nuts rather than bolts. So they've got a stud. It actually makes wheel fitting a lot easier. It's proper like old school, almost like race car sort of style. So yeah, I'm going to take this off now and then show you what I need to do next. And I might say I've just jacked it up and it's on two stands on front and it's chopped at the back and the handbrake's on. So we're well safe. You might be thinking, oh, I'm on loose ground here, but it's steady, it's on. It's not gonna come up, it's not gonna fall. Cameraman's just gone to get me a mat to sit on, because I forgot it. This is a little small one. See, it should be a 19, but you end up putting a 20 on it or 21. It's a bit annoying, really. Bit of a pain when they do that. Certain places where they put a windy gun on it, it's never good. It's not proper. They always should teach you, but you always take a wheel off with a breaker bar, and you can put it back on with like a windy gun or an ugger-dugger. But in reality, you should just use a breaker bar all the time because you're just going to round them off. And you can over-tighten them with an ugger-dugger if you're not careful as well. So that's a bit of a pain. Oh, look at them. Look at the tread on that. They're brand new. We got them a few months ago because he was both foot fronts have gone way down in the 2 years we've had him. So look, brand new tyres off, that's an eBay special. Part worn, but nearly new. What a win. I'll just try now. This is the new nut, what we got off eBay, just to see if they fit. See if they're the right thread. Oh yeah, they fit on nicely there. So when we put them all back together, we should have some nice shiny nuts. What's always a bonus, you can't beat having shiny nuts. So here's the setup as we speak. This is a 160 MGZR 160 setup, so bigger carrier, and it's a big vented disc. I forgot what the millage are on them, but they're much meatier setup than what JJ should have on. And when we put the bringing him back to OEM stand, you'll notice we're putting solid discs on him, and this will be a lot smaller. And then we're going to have a big bleed up after as well, because I've got to bleed both sides. Once you take these off, we'll get in the system and we'll do that last. So there we go. I might bring it in closer so you can have a look. I'll just turn my wheel out there so it gives me better leverage on the two bolts to take out the caliper, and then eventually get to the carrier behind. And before I'll take off, I'm going to take the screw out the disc so it's not spinning, so I can get it out. I've got my impact gun to take that out, and then I'll start dismantling the rest. I think that's the plan. Or maybe we might take this off first. Maybe we might take the caliper off first. Yeah, right, let's get on with it. These, I should say, are actually worth quite a bit of money, 160 calipers. They're quite rare. You can't buy them new anymore. People believe you can buy them new, but they're actually 120 brakes you're buying and not 160. So they're quite rare beauties, these are. They're like rocking horse poo, yeah? So, yeah, they're good. We got them. We've put them in storage. Maybe a spare set for Noel. But there you go. We'll get it on. Look at that nipple. Look how rusty that nipple is. Right, let's get on with it. It's a 12. I haven't done one of these for ages. Last time I did it was Gordon, who's behind camera. I put new calipers on him. And I always forget that the bolts in the calipers, where if you're doing BMs, it's an Allen key. You know, it's proper old school on there. I might actually get my breaker bar on it, get it off. Might just have to push it back a bit there to get a bit of leverage on here. I've got behind camera. Everything's behind camera. All my tools are behind camera, so hold on. Bear with us. My Sealy magnet tray. So yeah, we've taken him back stock, making fully stock again, so his brakes should work better. And I must say that we're not doing this because we thought, oh, we'll spend money turning back to stock. It's actually a real reason why we're doing it. It's because he's not this side, but the other side actually seized up on the journey going down south. So we thought, a better time, we'll get it done now, like, you know. So that's the whole reason we didn't go out and spend a lot of money and bring him back to stock. Even though we like doing that on this channel, we like stockness and making everything OEM, we actually had a reason to do this. Because actually, JJ isn't stock, he's got quite a custom engine on him. So he probably would leave these on and just get a master cylinder, a 160 master cylinder. But we might as well just go back stop, because the car behind you, Gordon, what you've never really seen much, he's got stock brakes set up and they're sharp, they're really good. Really, really good. So right. Now that's one caliper off, 160 caliper off. Get it all over me mat. So that's one. Maybe send them off and get them refurbed at Big Red. So we got them for a future date. And the pads, still got a bit of meat on them still, like there. Still got a bit of new EBCs on. So we got some good, decent stopping power, because we have got that on Gordon behind us. What's got some good brakes, like, because they stock, like I said before, but also because they got EBCs on. Now we'll take the caliper off now. Leverage. A bit tight. Right, I want to come in now. I can tell they haven't been off for a while. The guy we actually bought this off actually did put these brakes on about 2 years ago. That's who put the 160 brakes on. We never put them on, we bought them like this. They're on there. Cameraman's just gone off to get the copper grease. You bring every tool and you're manageable. Everything to the job, and you always forget copper grease, mat to sit on. That's about it, that's all I've really forgot. And I've got my gloves on today, what's a novelty. I actually suffer from a bit of dermatitis in my hands. And my mum said, oh, you need gloves. So eventually I went and bought some gloves the other day. Some nice ones, some nice tight fit gloves. So I can keep my hands clean. Oh. Down there. So that's the big caliper. The springs in, I might have to swap them on to the other ones, but hopefully the other calipers The other carrier's Cummel springs. I haven't really looked at them yet, they're still in the box. If they don't fit, we could be putting this all back together again. Look at that, that's nice. Nicely done. That down there. There. Right, it's 2 weeks later. I lubed all my discs off, went on holiday, did a Patreon video tour thing, came back, we lubed the disc up, and then we took the brakes apart today. I'm actually doing the other side. When you saw us last, I was on the other side, and the disc managed to come off. We've still got to do the other side, where we did have the problem on that last video. But that's what the new setup's like. Stock solid disc, stock carrier, stock caliper, and some EBC pads. Oh, you only use the best for T. So now I'm going to go on to the other side, do that, and then we're going to bleed them up. Just taking me bungee cord off. This holded me caliper up. I holded the caliper up first, just in case the disc didn't come off again. And then obviously it did, so I didn't need that then. The disc is finally off. We've been whacking it hard. Actually, between you and me, the cameraman actually took it off. The secret cameraman this time. Yeah, actually, no, it's the Patreon cameraman. And it's...
Well, to be honest with you, Thomas actually did all the work before, which eased it off.
Yeah, I did. As you'd say, I did do some really big hammer blows on it. But the cameraman just got down and you got a big hammer on it. And it come off. There you go. So that's what we've been fighting with, that disc. Now we can rebuild it back with new disc, new carry putter, and some pads. And then we're on to bleeding it up.
Top hat.
Right, I've run brand new disc, brand new caliper, brand new carrier, caliper, and two pads, and we've fastened it all up. Now it's time to a bit of bleeding now, about pump, hold, and then you let it off, and all the liquid and the air comes out into a little jar, and you see the bubbles in the bottom. We'll try and film that, show you the bubbles in the bottom. And then I lock it off and then go pump and we do it again until we get all the bubbles out of the system and we've got to do it on both sides. That's the next plan. Filling up me resin for me brake fluid. I'll fill it up tip top here. And this is so I can put the pipe in the bottom and see the bubbles when we're bleeding. Right. Go and pump it 6 times again. Again, still got bubbles in it. Tiny bit, one more time. Right, putting the wheel back on now. Look at that. Monogram. And an early dash. Look, pre-project drive dashboard. Whoa. Oh, didn't see you come in there. Just reading me book. Hope you enjoyed today's video of doing an OEM setup on JJ the MGZR, going from 160 setup back to stock because, well, pretty much the 160 brake setup seized up and it was just more cost effective really. Better to get stock set up than get a 160 brake calipers fixed. So they've actually been sold to Kevin, one of my Patreon supporters, and he's putting them on his ZS now. Now, since the end of that video, when I was bleeding the brakes up, the brakes actually went really bad again and really, really soft and mushy. And it's to do with we took it back apart And the pipe, the brake pipe that goes to the caliper, it has two washers on it, on the bolt side and the caliper side, and one of the washers was missing. I thought it was on, but it wasn't. So we went on Rimmers and got another one and shipped the next day. It came, we fitted it, and it was fine. And then we've been to Derbyshire since, doing a bit of TE new railway history videos, and it was pretty good on hills. It's all right. It's the right setup for the car now, rather than the wrong setup. So if you've enjoyed today's video, make sure you give us a like, a subscribe, a comment below. Always comment. That's the most important thing on TE. Always comment. And remember to, and there's also Patreon below if you like to support what TE does. And also remember to click that big bell. Ding!
Hello? Hello? Hey? Hey? Hi? TE? Are you there? TE? TE? Are you there? It's Barry the Og here. Hi. Your best MG, buddy. I've been getting into these MGs, I'll tell you. Just can anyone see my... Oh, hang on. What's that? Oh, what's that? Oh, hey. Hey, let me have a look at that. Oh, hey, up. MG Z-cars. Oh. Hey, the ZR. Our posh Super Mini became a cult car among yous. Hey, this is great, this is. It was in many ways the least developed at Z cars, certainly in terms of its engineering, but the ZR or X30 was a remarkably successful car given background behind its development. Under skin it was essentially a Rover 25 GTI, but with slightly firmer dampers. Essentially, the 25 was a pretty decent car to drive, and that weighed in the ZR's favour, especially with the MG 25 GTI's faster steering rack. On an open and twisty road, it could do very well indeed, while its performance was comparably better than many of its rivals. Hi, it's Barry Og here. Hi, I'm getting into show business. Daddy Wrinkles is managing me, you know, and I'm going to be a big star like TE and Rod the Raven. I do love show business. Anyway, where were I? There were four powertrain choices. At entry level, there was a ZR105, which came with 1.4 litre 16 valve Rover K series. Oh, missus. An eager and lively unit with 130 PS. It was far greater power output than similar size 1.4s from other manufacturers. Next up was ZR120 with a 118 PS, 1.8 unit, followed by VVC, not BBC, VVC. Have a lie down. It's Barry Og here. Oh, good night.